Hello everyone, welcome to a video lecture on Satellite Earth Station. Myself K.R. Biradar, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Let us start with the learning outcomes first. At the end of this session, students will be able to illustrate the Satellite Earth Station and its types. Before discussing what is an Earth station, the various subsystems of satellite communications are Earth station, are also called the Earth segment, space segment, and the link between Earth and the space segments. In this topic, I am going to discuss a part of the Earth segment which is called the Earth station. Now look for definition of or what is a Earth station is. Any transmitting or receiving system which sends or receives signal to and from satellite. That means we can transmit the signal from our station to the satellite, and also it receives the signals from the satellite. Earth station is a significant element in satellite communication network. That means Earth station plays a very important role in satellite communication system. The function of an Earth station is to receive from or transmit information to the satellite. That means in the uplink, the Earth station transmit the information from Earth station to the satellite during the uplink. Whereas in the downlink, the satellite will transmit back to the Earth station. The design of an Earth station configuration depends upon many factors and its location. The various factors of designing the Earth stations are maybe transmitted power or transmitting power, receiving power, and size of the antenna, and noise to temperature ratio, and noise introduced in the network, etc. And location of Earth stations are maybe it is an Earth on the surface of Earth, or it may be in the ship of sea, or it may be airborne. Then question arises, what are the major subsystems of Earth station? Pause the video for 2 minutes and write your answer. I think 2 minutes over. Major subsystems of the Earth stations are transmitter, receiver, antenna, and tracking equipment. Transmitter is used to transmit the signals from the Earth station to the satellite, and receiver is used to receive the signal from the satellite to the Earth station. Antenna, which is used to radiate the electromagnetic waves, and also receives the electromagnetic waves transmitted from the satellite. The tracking equipment, which is used to alter the position of the antenna up, down, right, left, etc., depends on the position of the satellite. This pictorial representation of satellite communication system consists of, there are Earth stations, that is, one is a transmitting Earth station, another one is a receiving Earth station, and there is a satellite here. Then the signal which is transmitted from Earth station to the satellites is called the uplink. And the received signal, or the signal which is received from the satellite to the Earth station, is called the downlink. Here, satellite acts as a completely repeater, which takes the signals and amplify, remove noise, and retransmit again. So, can it not possible directly to do from transmitting Earth station to receiving Earth station? This is not possible because for a longer distance, these two antennas are not comes under direct line of sight. That is why here satellite acts as a repeater which will take the signal from the transmitting Earth station and so process the data and retransmit again to the receiving Earth station. Then look for the block diagram of Earth station. The Earth station mainly consists of a transmitter, the receiver, and antenna system, and the tracking subsystem. So whatever the at the top side you can see, that is an encoder, modulator, up converter, high power amplifier. These that is the blocks comes under the transmitter. Whereas down you can see this is nothing but a reverse process of whatever the transmitter has done. That is called the receiver. There is an antenna system which can transmit or radiate the electromagnetic waves, and also it receives the electromagnetic waves from the satellite. And there is a tracking system. Tracking system is used to alter the position of the antenna at their station, depends on the position of the satellite. There is a terrestrial network and baseband equipment. This flow and what are its functions, we shall see these things. Let's see first transmitter. The digital information enters at baseband equipment, that is BBE, from terrestrial network. Whatever the information which is available from the user to be transmitted will come from the terrestrial network to the baseband equipment. Encoder, which includes, that is, the error correcting bits, which is used to minimize the bit error rate present in the signal. So in satellite communication, the intermediate frequencies are either 70 MHz by transponder having bandwidth of 36 MHz or 140 MHz by a transponder having bandwidth of 72 MHz. These two can be used one at a time. Up converter performs the frequency conversion of modulated signal to higher frequency. Generally, the modulated signal which is having a radio frequency, but it is not that much higher frequency which can transmit for longer distance. We need to alter the frequency, or we need to increase the frequency in the at the transmitter so that it can reach to the receiver safely and perfectly. That will be done by this up converter block. This signal which is coming out from the up converter will be amplified by using high power amplifier. Because the frequency is a RF signal which is having very high frequency, we need to use the high power amplifier to amplify before radiating or transmitting the signal to the space. The earth station antenna transmit these signals, or earth station antenna radiates this signal. Then comes under the receiver. The earth station antenna receives downlink signal coming from the satellite. So the signal which is received is RF signal. It is having very high frequency, but it is a low strength signal. That is why we need to have, or we need to amplify that signal. That will be done by low noise amplifier. Low noise amplifier performs the amplification of the RF signal which is having a high frequency. RF signal can be down converted into IF value. Whatever the in transmitter we have done, that is up converted, here you need to down convert into IF value, because the RF signal cannot be directly demodulated. That is why we need to convert down that frequency, higher frequency, into medium frequency, to a IF value or intermediate frequency value. The function of decoder is just opposite to that of encoder. So it produces an error-free binary information by removing error correction bits. This binary information is given to baseband equipment for further processing and then delivers to the terrestrial network. This as transmitter we have done, that is taken from terrestrial network and placed it in a broadband equipment. Here the signal which is coming from broadband equipment will be processed and delivers to the terrestrial network. Then earth station antenna. The major parts of the earth station antenna are feed system and antenna reflector. So the feed system is used here to separate, or we can transmit the, that is, signal and also receive the signal simultaneously. Will be done by this feed system. Then the antenna reflector. Antenna reflector perform gain can be increased, or high gain signals will be produced this antenna reflector. These two parts combinedly together radiates or receives electromagnetic waves. Then last is tracking system. The tracking system present in the earth station performs mainly two functions, that is satellite acquisition and the satellite tracking. That means antenna which is that is revolve around the earth is not in a fixed orbit. It will be moving, and earth is also moving, because the position of the antenna at the earth station should have to point towards the satellite. That is why we need to move the earth station antenna towards pointing to the satellite. That will be done by this tracking subsystem. There are different ways we can do this tracking system, that is automatic tracking, manual tracking, and the program tracking. So among these three tracking system, program tracking is accurate one, we can do automatically. So different types of earth station. The earth station can be classified on off depends on the size of the antenna and the service provided, and also another method is, and their usage also, you can classify the earth stations. Depends on the size and the service provided, there are three types of earth station, that is fixed satellite service earth station, second one is broadcast satellite service earth station, third one is mobile satellite service earth station. So depends on the usage how we are going to divide, that is classify the earth stations, are single function stations, gateway stations, and the teleports. These things we shall see or discuss later. These are the references I have considered to prepare the above PPT. Thank you.